afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your episode 591, part 2. Your daily bread pastor. Sorry for the loud motorcycle. You're going to get that out when I'm out in this room. You'll get those loud noises because the road's right there. So, but today, we're going to be dealing with disagreement. We're going to learn how to deal with disagreement, basically. This is your Thursday, January 6th, part 2 video. Today's author is Kimya Lauder. Lauder. K-I-M-Y-A L-O-D-E-R. Kimya Lauder. I just don't know how to pronounce it perfectly, but it's Kimya, K-I-M-Y-A, and it's Lauder, Lauder, L-O-D-E-R, so. But today's passage is derived from Colossians 3, 12 through 14. If you're excited about this one, smash that like button. Comment, how do you deal with disagreements? That's a good one just to try to go along with the title. How do you deal with disagreements? What is your strategy of dealing with disagreement? Subscribe if you do, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me get to at least 25 subscribers in 9 days for episode 600. So, dealing with disagreement. This person writes, the social media powerhouse Twitter caused a platform where people all over the world express opinions in short sound bites. So in recent years, however, this formula has become more complex as individuals have begun to leverage Twitter as a tool to reprimand others for attitudes and lifestyles they disagree with. I don't even use Twitter, so you gotta worry about me doing all this crap. I don't tweet. I do hashtags on my Facebook post. It's just the way I do. I just do hashtags because I know Facebook and Twitter, they're linked. So if you put a hashtag on your Facebook post, the hashtag will show up on Twitter, but you don't have to be on Twitter. So, but I just don't do Twitter itself. So I'm just putting that out in the forefront. So if you try to look for me on Twitter, you ain't gonna find me because I don't Twitter. I don't tweet. So log on to the platform on any given day and you'll find the name of at least one person trending. That's basically what the hashtags, you get a lot of posts with that hashtag. It says that subject is trending. So trending, click on that name and you'll find millions of people expressing opinions about whatever controversy has emerged. So we learn to publicly criticize everything from the beliefs people hold to the clothes they wear. The reality, however, is that a critical and an unloving attitude doesn't align with who God has called us to be as believers in Jesus. So while there will be times when we have to deal with disagreement, the Bible reminds us that as believers, we're to always conduct ourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Colossians 3:12. Instead of being harshly critical, even of our enemies, God urges us to bear with each other and forgive one another if we have a grievance. Verse 13. So this treatment isn't limited to the people whose lifestyles and beliefs we agree with. Even when it's difficult, may we extend grace and love to everyone we encounter as Christ guides us, recognizing that we've been redeemed by His love. Amen? So consider a time when you were quick to criticize a friend or a stranger. What was that result? And what could have you done differently to honor God and the individual. Those are some good. Ponder that by saying this. Heavenly Father, I know I fall short of your glory every day. Thank you for your unconditional love. Help me strive to be more like you by being patient and gentle with others, whoever that may be. But today's Bible reading is Genesis 16 and 17 and Matthew 5, 27 through 48. Yesterday you were supposed to read 1 through 26. Today you read 27 through 48. And I think that, I believe that is the rest of chapter 5, if I'm not mistaken. It must be, because tomorrow it starts the first half of chapter 6. So tomorrow, for your part 2 of 592, for Friday, January 7th, we're going to be talking about Genuine Hope from Bill Crowder. And it's derived from 1 Peter 1, 3-9. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that one probably just a little bit. Let me get done with my turning point, and then tomorrow's first part of the video, and then I'll get to it. Coming up later tonight, after 7, in your first Thursday turning point of 2022, for Thursday, January 6th, episode 130, we're going to be talking about snowstorms and blenders. Ooh, what's that going to be all about? Snowstorms and blenders. Your beginning passage is Proverbs 29:17 from the NIV, which we'll read that in my version. We'll read that verse within Proverbs 29:15-17. So 15, 16, 17. So we'll get to compare the NIV version and my version to see what's different. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 7. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. We've got some quick videos for today, so I'm not getting on subject and rambling. So, but keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And I'll see y'all later. Peace out. Until then. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Thursday afternoon. Come back again after 7 for snowstorms and blenders, and we'll find out what that's all about. With that said, see ya. Goodbye.